Hey guys, welcome to Silverstone's POV. So today we got one of our customers with the 2003 Ram 1500, and his complaint was he heard a grinding noise in the left front wheel. He thought it's a wheel bearing, so that's why we brought it up in the shop. And so first thing, we just confirm the steering and suspension. So when I shake like this, I can't feel any play up and down for the steering wheel bearing. It's not played. But the next step, we're gonna look through it and maybe drive on the air to listen to it, see any wheel bearing. Well, check this side also. There's no tie rod and play that I can feel. And also, it's no wheel bearing play in and out, up and down. So now we're gonna put it up a little bit higher, and I got Emma in the truck so she can drive on the air and see if we can listen to the front wheel bearing. So okay, here we got it up, and just a quick look around first and see if it see anything obvious, anything out shape. So look at brake rotor and brake pad look pretty good, so the grinding is not brake. Also on this side, and when I look at the axle shaft on this side, I can see look like there's brown and some very shiny metal came out from the actual shop, so maybe that's a problem. And when I look on this side, actual shop, we can see fluid coming out, and yeah, the seal is kind of like destroyed. Fluid came out. Shop hasn't played much. Oh, but look this side. So I've got a lot of play. Okay, start it up, put in neutral, and switch to four-wheel drive high, and dry it. See if you can hear anything. Yeah, so the grinding on passenger side, not the driver side, like what he said, but yeah, actual shaft. And when driving, so the front drive shaft moving, the front deck is moving, but the noise was in here, and the shaft that came out from the dip is spinning, right?
Yeah.
So the shaft is spinning, but the actual shaft is not. Yeah, so we have to see what happened. Probably the spline in here is all gone. That's why that's shiny metal, a little metal came out from there. Yeah, so what? That's the problem. Hopefully it's nothing much inside the dip. But look, the fluid came out on this side. But this side sharp, it looks okay. But I really don't like that. Seal look destroyed a little bit, and the fluid came out, so we have to check that. But this side for sure, we have to pull this actual shaft out and to check the spline in here and see how it look like. Yes guys, the front depth cover is off and the CV actual shaft is out from the intermediate shaft. Very quick and easy. So just need to disconnect the upper control arms and the outer tie rod end. And as you can see, the spline inside the CV extra shaft is badly worn out. That's why it's making that grinding noise. And also the intermediate shaft spline is pretty badly worn out as well. So it needs to be replaced. So when I'm shaking, turn the shaft to check the front dip gear assembly, it feels okay, just a regular wear and tear due to the mileage and the year of the vehicle. And when I'm shaking this shaft on the driver's side, it's a little bit of play as well, but it's not bad. Just the gear inside has play on the side gear right there. So it's not the actual shaft. So this actual shaft needs to be removed as well and replaced the actual seals right there. The gear assembly is good, so just need a new fluid. And this intermediate shaft needs to be replaced, and also the seals right there. And the CV extra shaft on the driver's side, on the passenger side. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for the next video to replace two front axle seal, intermediate shaft, and CV extra shaft. Thanks guys, and have a great day.